Hello everyone, how are you all? Welcome to SD Chase World and I hope you are doing well. Today we will going to see an interesting match of round 5 Ultibox Norwich Chess 2018, and this is the match between Grandmaster Fabiano Caruana versus Grandmaster Sergey Karakin. Both are the World Chess Championship challengers. So before going to it, don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit that bell icon. Now you have done that, let's go for it. In this game, Caruana Fabiano has a white pieces and Sergey Karakin has a black pieces. Caruana started with c4 and knight to f6, knight to c3 and e5, English opening, 2 knight variation. After that, knight to f3 was played and knight to c6, e3 and bishop to b4 attacking on this knight. So here queen goes for queen to c2 protecting it, and here Karakin immediately go for bishop captures on c3. And queen captures on c3. He is just losing his bishop pair in the start of the game, but he has some plan for it. After that, queen to e7, now activating a queen, b3, now supporting this c4 pawn, and black is ready to castle. So black castles here, bishop to b2 was played, supporting this queen, and this queen, bishop and knight are attacking on this pawn. So here rook to e8, adding one defender. After that, a3 was played and going for this b4 move to stop it. A5 was played, and after that h3, making space for king after castling, and b6 supporting that a5 pawn. Bishop to e2, now white is ready for castling. Bishop to b7, activating a bishop, and it is now aiming at the king side. After that, white castles, and d5 was played. Black started his attack. Now this pawn must be captured. C captures on d5 and knight captures on d5, attacking on the queen. Queen have to move, so queen goes for queen to c2. After that, e4 was played, now attacking on the knight. Knight don't have really good square to go, it can develop to this g5 square, so it goes for knight to h2, retreating it. Queen to g5 was played. Now this queen is aiming at this g2 pawn, and this is a really critical situation because now black is already gone for the attack. Here several moves are possible, keeping this knight on f4 square anytime. This rook can go for the attack. So f4 was played. Now this pawn is attacking on the queen, but here in passant is possible. E takes on f3 and knight takes on f3. So e takes on f3 is an en passant rule. Queen to g3 was played. Now Karakin already tightening this position. There are some threats. This bishop is aiming towards the g2 pawn. Also these two knights are really dangerous. And here important move, rook to f2 was played. Now this rook is protecting this g2 pawn, and white has a relief now. As you can see, if we will play any of the move like rook a to c1, then definitely there is a plan. Knight to f4 was played. You just have to capture this knight because this this knight is aiming on this g2 square, and queen is definitely going to be capture it. Of course, pawn captures on f4, and here rook takes this bishop, and stopping this attack is really impossible. So considering all, rook to f2 is a really important move. After that, rook a to d8 was played, now activating the rook, supporting this knight over here, and bishop to c4 attacking that knight. Knight don't have really good square to go, its forward squares are already occupied, and it just have to retreat, and going for this e7 square is not a good option because it is blocking this rook. Knight goes for knight to f6 and bishop takes on f6. Now pawn must capture, pawn captures on f6, and now we can see g file is open for white to attack. Rook a to f1, now supporting this two rooks, and after this knight move, this pawn is going to fall. To protect it, rook to d6 was played. Now rook is protecting this f6 pawn. After that, b4 was played, now going for the attack. So next move will be this b5. So here Karakin goes for a takes on b4 and a takes on b4. Now you can see this knight is attacking on this pawn, but Karakin don't go for it, he just go for rook to e7. And now why this rook to e7 move? If here knight captures this pawn on b4, Now definitely bishop captures on f7 and there are lots of threat. Of course this bishop must be captured because it is aiming towards this rook. So king have to capture. King captures on f7. White can go for any of the move like queen takes on c7. Now this queen is going for this bishop and this rook over here. To stop it, black will definitely go for rook to e7 move. After that you can see this rook can't be captured because queen is looking for it, and of course this rook is defending this bishop over here, but white can easily defend this. He can just easily goes for knight to g5, and of course check from knight, it's unstoppable. King have to move or queen must capture this knight, so white is forcing for this move. Queen captures on g5 and now this rook don't have any support, so queen captures on d6. Now knight to d5 can be played, supporting this knight over here, and after that rook to f5, now attacking on this queen and the knight. So queen have to retreat, queen have to go for queen to g6 and rook takes on d5. After that bishop takes on d5 and queen takes on d5. Although material is equal on the board, but white has really good pawn structure and this pawn is identical, it can anytime fall, so this can be possible. Considering all this, rook to e7 was played, and now black has a good position here. These two rooks are controlling board also, but bad thing for black is this g file is open. After that b5 was played, now attacking on the knight. Knight go for knight to e5 and after that knight to d4. Now this knight has a really good position, it is controlling a really important square, also protecting this pawn on b5. Now we can see this knight can capture this bishop, but instead of this here Karagin goes for bishop to c8. Now this bishop can capture this h3 pawn since this pawn on g2 is pinned. Avoiding it, king to h1 was played, and why this knight is not capturing this bishop, because this knight is really important. It can anytime go for this g4 and f3 square, which is really dangerous for white. So king to g7 was played, and after that bishop to e2, king to h8, and after that queen to c3 was played. Now king to g7 and here bishop to d1 was played. Now this bishop is going for this diagonal. Now there is really strong threat. Knight to f5 is definitely going to be a disaster because it is immediately going for the check. Also it is covering these two rooks and a queen, so it is disastrous move. But importantly, this bishop is looking forward for the square. So considering all this, king to g8 and after that bishop to c2 was played. So going for the square, queen to h4, now protecting this pawn since this bishop is looking forward to this pawn. Rook to f4 was played, attacking on the queen. Queen goes for queen to g3, but instead of capturing the pawn here, bishop to f5 was played. Now attacking on this bishop. Of course bishop can't capture. If bishop captures, then knight captures here, and winning one of the rook or a queen. So definitely bishop moves to bishop to b7, and after that bishop to e4 was played. Still want to capture the bishop. Here also bishop can't capture. If bishop captures, then rook captures the bishop, and still there is a square available for this knight, and there are three pieces which are hanging. One of the piece can only move. So bishop to c8 was played, repeating move, and here Karuna can't repeat. If he repeat, then it is going to be a triple repetition and it's draw. So here Karuna goes for queen to a3, now going for this a8 square, attacking on this bishop. Considering this, Karagin goes for king to g7, and after this move queen to a8 was played, attacking on this bishop. Now this bishop can move for this d7 square, but if it moves, that is bishop to d7, then definitely this move bishop to f5 is really dangerous because it is capturing this bishop anyhow. This bishop don't have a good square to move. So Karagin go for attacking mode. Bishop takes on h3, g takes on h3, and queen takes on h3 with check. King have to move. King to g1 was played. Rook takes on d4. Because if pawn takes this rook here, then definitely this queen to g3 check, bishop to g2, bishop had to retreat, and knight to g4, and black is threatening this checkmate on h2. Of course, rook can take the knight, but queen takes here, and after that there is a possibility that rook can go for this e2 square attacking on this bishop. But here Karakin also miss one move, and Caruana goes for it and going for winning position. So if you want to go and find that move, then you can pause video here. So that move is bishop to g2 attacking on the queen, and now this rook is hanging. Of course queen have to move because queen is important. Queen goes for g3 and rook takes on d4, now losing the rook and the bishop in this game. White is completely winning here. After that, knight to g4 was played, now still threatening this queen to h2 checkmate. Rook to f3 was played, attacking on this queen here, and if queen goes for this h2, then of course bishop can go for this f1 square, and queen don't have anywhere to go. This immediately stop the attack. Instead of that, queen to e1 was played, check, and bishop to f1 was played. This is the 41th move, so there is no limitation for time here, but this is definitely a difficult game to continue. So Karakin resigns on this position. And why is resigns? Because this rook is aiming towards this knight. Of course this knight must be moved, and queen don't have any hope to go for a checkmate. Here black can simply try for a draw, but of course there is a Caruana Fabiano challenger 2018, and it is going to be a difficult. So instead of going for this, Grandmaster Sergey Karakin resigns this game. Sergey Karakin is a 2016 challenger, and Caruana Fabiano is 2018 challenger. So there is a definitely fight for Magnus Carlsen over here, and Fabi gets his first point in this tournament. And of course Fabiano Caruana and Sergey Karakin has the same position, having 2 points. So we will look forward for 6th round, and let's see what happened. I hope you like this video. If yes, then go ahead, hit that like button and share this with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe the channel. To subscribe, hit that red circle. You can watch my previous videos over here. You can join me on Facebook, Google Plus, Twitter. You just have to search SD's Chase World. And thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.